Okay, hello everyone.
Wow.
I'm the Metal Addict. I don't know what's going on. I'm pretty sure. Okay, so we're doing NIS Fixed at the road course. We're pretty sure this is a standing start. Because we're not on the backstretch where we normally for a rolling start should go. I'm not sure what's going to happen. This could be a standing start. I haven't practiced a standing start. Because it shouldn't be a standing start. Please tell me this is a full pace lap. Like, please tell me this is a joke.
Additional sets of tires for this race. Be smooth.
Nope, this is a standing start, motherfucker.
Green flag.
Okay, everything was controlled. Standing start in NASCAR. This is fun.
Still there. Clear.
Good job, iRacing.
Still there. Still there at your door. Clear. On your right. Still there.
Yeah, this is top split.
Still there.
Trust me, this is not going to be fun. I'm not going to finish well. I'm going to have to survive. Okay, we're good. Again, this is top split. We are going off road rating in an oval series, which is fine. I like how they do this, but just understand I'm bad. So it's gonna be more about me surviving 35 laps than me trying to outrun people. Yeah, we had a standing start. That was fun. Just another friendly reminder, don't touch the curb. Curbs are bad. Really trying to take care of my tires. Like, in these cars, it really, really matters. They're really trying to be easy on throttle, because as soon as you start heating them up, you're never getting them pulled back down. These tires get super hot no matter what. So the longer you can prolong it, the better off you are.
right side. Clear. On your right, in and out. Left side only. Still there. All clear, my man. Left side. Still there.
He's probably not happy with that.
Clear.
Thank you for not forcing it too wide there. Okay, so I'm thinking top 15 is going to start turning into goal this race. Oh, I got to stop sliding to the bus stop like that. Got the draft in these things. Gonna keep the guy behind me with me. I just need a couple clean laps where I can just run my own thing. Find out if I'm actually faster than anyone ahead of me or not. In this split, probably not. Problem is I get slowed up and then the guy behind me, like, it's like a never ending cycle of just losing spots. If I get past, I get slowed up, so the guy behind me gets closer, gets a run, I lose another spot. like, I have not had much of a chance this race to be offensive because I had to be defensive. Which is probably because I'm slow, but I keep thinking at some point tires are going to start mattering and people are going to start coming back. I think I've done a good job of keeping them under me, but I just need to stop sucking. Oh no, I'm slow in this. I have not ran a good lap, really, all race. I just need a point to get into a rhythm and start trying to work my way back up. But the guys ahead of me haven't completely left me. I got another guy. Coming up behind me, it's probably a bunch faster. Oh, finally, I hit the bus stop. Without sliding through the middle. We at least made one pass in this race. We can say that. I do not know how people are getting through that last chicane so much better.
Left side. Still there.
But let him go.
Door quarter clear.
No use battling them. Problem is, I'm probably taking the lines I do for GT3 when I really shouldn't. Oh, that was a bit deep. So 31 is starting to struggle.
Clear.
So I think the one good thing I have is I think I'm really consistent. I'm not that fast, but I think overall I've been pretty consistent. I haven't had too many wiggles and whatnot. Man, I am able to charge in on the entrance to the bus stop. Just not breaking quite enough through the middle. We're just better at different parts of the track. He really killed me the second half of that. Oh, now I'm gonna have to defend. Destroyed my right front getting in there, or left front. Locked up something. Broke earlier than normal.
Still there.
And somehow still missed the bus stop.
Clear, clear, clear.
Thank you.
right side. Still there. Still there, door. Still there. On your clear, clear.
I got pinched out there. We're messed around and Julian's gone. He's gonna. He's gonna defend here, isn't he?
Clear, clear, clear.
And I missed. Bust up.
Now get back in that rhythm. Go again.
Shift up into fourth when I shouldn't have. All right, we got clear track. This is what I've been wanting this whole time. Just give me clear track and I think I'm okay. I got someone who did pit behind me. He's gonna be a lot faster. He's gonna have to be patient though. Or not. Thanks. Should have waited there. Like, me entering the corner is not right, not a really good time to decide, hey, I'm making a move. GT cars, cool. Stock cars, no. Like, I'm pretty much already, here's what I'm doing. And then try to enter the line without killing us both. Like, I very almost, like, he almost ended his own race there. Yeah, I'm on hot old tires, and you're gonna pull a move like that. Just because he's short pit trying to get an advantage. Too wide for that last chicane is not a thing. Guys, I'm fresh.
On your left.
Fuck.
On your clear. Clear. I better get that rhythm again.
Wasn't expecting to make a move around the outside there. Like, in hot, with hot tires, any unexpected moment becomes way more dramatic just because of how horribly these cars handle to begin with, and then on tires that are just completely on fire. Okay, now he's... lose a lot of time here. Okay, we're gonna pit this time. We're gonna have a better second half of the race. We're going to have a better second half.
One on the right side.
Oh,
right.
Come on.
Still there. Clear.
I got rear end damage. He had to be on my ass. 25 seconds. Fuck me. That's gonna really hurt speed.
Go back, go, go back, go. That's a nice stop, guys. Good pit stop, boys. Be mindful, you only have one set of cars remaining.
Not much, just struggling. Even if I wasn't hitting that guy was gonna hit me. Okay, this is the Daytona Road course. I know what I'm doing. Let's start acting like I do. We got a whole another half the race. You gotta be mindful of tires. Yes, that is a name. That is a name. Sure. Hey, what's going on, Matt? Yes. By far. I cannot stand the trucks. I haven't tried Xfinity really, but... I'm having fun. I'm not good at it, but I'm having fun. I was really overdriving at the first part of the race, which makes me mad because I'm doing a lot better now. Yeah, but we needed the sausages. Yeah, he's in the Porsche Invitational content creator race thing. God, I'm not nearly big enough. Like, the names they have in there are people who have talent and have massive followings. I have a nice little cult following, and I'm happy with that. But I love you guys. I got a nice little group of people, and it's amazing. Both on the YouTube and Twitch side. I'm really setting it up just to try to get 19th. I got nothing else to gain, so I'm just trying to save the car and stay with them and try to make a move late or hopefully get around and run away. He's like me. He's not very, this 23 is good. It's just, he can't keep putting the laps together. Same thing I struggle with. I go on streaks where I'm really good, then I overheat the tires for like 5 laps and I just keep doing dumb things. I don't think I'm letting the car roll enough. Really wish I would have stuck to 16-1 steering ratio. Oh god, Coda, fuck that. Not touching that with a 10-foot pole. I do not like that track in the least. Depending on how the car bounces on that curve, I can get on throttle really early, or I bounce and slip. Like, it's just really, it's really odd. I'm losing like a second, if not more, through this last section of the course. Oh, yeah, league races. You know, if I drove like this through the rest of the race, I may have finished better. Yeah, Canada's pretty good. Man, we are really catching on the 18th, but we're not anywhere close enough to be able to make a move or catch him. I don't know what, I haven't tried much Xfinity. I keep missing that up chip. That's halftime. I see me just hit the clutch. I'm missing too many shifts. Well, I had such a bad first half of the race, I like realized I have to calm it down. Oh God, yeah. Like in qualifying, this is a 3.4K SOF. And there was a 2 second gap between first and 20th. Like, I don't know how some of these guys are hitting 52, like sevens and sixes in qualifying.
Okay.
Like, yeah, there was guys in the 52s in qualifying times. Yeah, I am like my best lap, one of my best laps ever, at like a 54.8 or 7. Although I think I hit a 54.4 sometime in this race. That was, and I think that was a little bit drafted. I think I was following someone, so I had a bit of a draft down the backstretch and out of the bus stop. Faster than the guys ahead of me, and I blew the first half of this race so much that I didn't even give myself a chance. Yeah, that would have been nice. It is. Hey, we're up to 18th. I don't know how that happened. I didn't even realize that. So we only lost one spot. Through this whole mess of a race and all the things I did to mess this race up. We only lost one spot overall. Yeah. I'm wondering what brake bias they're using too. That could have a lot to do with it as well. Like, I'm guessing they probably moved it up or down a couple percent. But it wouldn't shock me. Moved it to where you can drive in a bit deeper. I've done a lot better on my tires this run.
to five to go.
Running pretty consistent times now. Yeah, I've been gaining on the three ahead of me. Like, I've caught up for like 2 or 3 seconds. The problem is I had like 3 issues in a matter of 10 laps that cost me like 15 seconds. Maybe not that. Yeah, they're close enough, they could wreck each other. I'm just like, man, if I could have driven this consistently in the first part of the race, I could have had such a better finishing position. I've kept the tires under me way better. Like, the car just feels so much better this run. So the guy in 15th is faster, but like, and maybe 16th, the 17th, he's the guy I've been catching. I'm just too little too late. Oh, this is my first really bad bus stop in a bit. Now I'm starting to rev up my tires a bit. I didn't get lapped. There's that. I didn't get lapped. There's that. Yep, now the tire's starting to not be happy. Oh, there was a change for 15th. One more. All right, there's a checker flag. Oh man, 18th. We lost one spot.
pit crew is fucking awful. Friday was fucking awful. I mean, you know, it all starts on our part on Friday too, but
I think we're still gonna gain iRating though. I think we're still gonna gain iRating. Yeah, Garrett destroyed the field. Garrett destroyed the field. Man, there's a lot of cars here within a few second gap. I just had too many mistakes. That rear bumper damage probably isn't helping anything that second run either. Probably not affecting it as much as I want to think it is, but definitely didn't help. Just really sucks, but these things are so hard to drive. They're like the V8 supercars. You don't have much room to make mistakes, and the guys who are good at it are really good. But still, we qualified 19th. We gained one spot. So we did have a net positive. And again, this was a standing start. I'm surprised it wasn't more carnage. Like, there wasn't much spinning. There wasn't much anything. I'm shocked. But it was better pace in the first half of the race. I think we could have been up here fighting for a top 15. But we'll take it. I think we gained iRating. Gained some safety. Well, no, we probably didn't gain safety rating, but either way, it was fun, even though it was pretty much me bitching the first half of the race. But you guys have come to expect it by now. That's what you get when you watch me. It's pretty much my thoughts live. Whether they're right or wrong, you pretty much get what I'm thinking as it happens. But hope you guys did enjoy the race. If you did, be sure to like, share, and subscribe. It does help the YouTube channel out when you do so. And if you're watching this on YouTube, follow me on Twitch, where you can catch some of the action live.